Yeah, these people should definitely be getting out of the way. If you see a sea lion running at you, you should also run. This is not like encountering a bear where playing dead might help you. Don't. Just run. Run away. Climb something? They can't climb. You do not want to get bit by one of these for reasons that we're going to talk about in this week's Behavior Breakdown. I'm KP, a marine biologist who's worked with a variety of sea lions. Videos of sea lions have been going viral this week after two sea lions chased beachgoers down in California. And an even crazier video where a child almost got her face ripped off. So let's take a closer look at these videos and see what's going on. Even though it looks like they're running towards these people, they're very clearly just trying to get back in the water. So I think it's more a situation where the sea lions are panicking. They're surrounded by people, but I don't really see them being truly aggressive. Sea lions are extremely fast on land. They can outrun you, or at least me. Schmel! Come here, Schmel! So if these sea lions really wanted to, they would have caught some of these people. Especially here at the end where they're actually entering into the water, they have much more mobility than humans could ever hope to. But they're just simply swimming past these people as they head out to the sea. And I guess that sort of raises the question as to why these sea lions were so close to these people to begin with. And that's the part that bugs me. We don't get to see the beginning of this situation because I feel like we're missing context. And you know how I love context. We don't see where these sea lions came from or what sparked this behavior. Obviously, they weren't just dropped in the middle of a crowded beach. So I think it's highly likely that these sea lions were minding their own business and people started crowding in on them. And I have good reason to believe this because just about every picture coming out of California in this time of the year is some tourist trying to take a selfie with a sea lion.
There are growing concerns tonight over the harassment of sea lions in La Jolla.
That happens far too often, as we see in this next video, which I've already seen. I actually took a look at that live with my followers over on my Twitch channel. Shameless plug, Twitch channel. So we cold open on a little girl sitting on the back of what looks to be a type of fur seal. And even though it's called a fur seal, it actually is a type of sea lion. And if you want to know the difference between sea lions and seals, you can click on this video right up here. Okay, it's only a 5-second long video. You can do this. Nothing fuels my white hot rage like parents putting their children in horrifying and scarring situations.
I have goosebumps. I am so mad.
I cannot in my head comprehend why anyone would do this ever. A bite from a seal or sea lion is horrifying. If you look at a seal or sea lion's teeth, they're often black from bacteria. And while this is very normal and even healthy for them, a scratch from one of their teeth can cause a horrible infection. It's something called seal finger and it requires like a 6-week antibiotic course. I cannot understand the mindset of somebody who walks up, sees a large dangerous animal minding its own business and goes, let's sit on it. But people in the comment section are saying natural selection. The kid should get what it deserves. No, stop. This has nothing to do with the kid. This is not the kid's fault. The child was told to do this. So that's the child endangerment portion of the video, which is not insignificant. But secondly, why are we harassing wild animals? And how do we not even recognize that this is harassment? Why has this become a part of our culture? What happened to just calmly and respectfully enjoying nature from a distance? I would like to know, like, how this went in their heads. Like, what was the vision? Because in my head, there could never have been a good outcome. Another thing to note is that this animal has pretty clearly, in my mind, been habituated to people. A fur seal this size would never let people approach it, get that close to it, you know, or sit on it. People have probably been feeding this animal, which reminds me of another sea lion attack. This actually happened near me. I was living in Vancouver, BC at the time, and this was in Steveston. which is an area unfortunately notorious for people feeding the seals and sea lions. Again, we have parents or guardians putting children in a clearly dangerous situation. But maybe this is a little bit of my problem. I've worked with animals for my entire career. For me, the behavior that this sea lion is exhibiting in this video is clearly aggressive. When he lunges up at the little girl, that's just a warning. It's like a mock charge, and I don't know how many warnings you get. Depends a little bit on the animal. So they're feeding the animal, and then they stopped. I think people want to believe they're forming a unique relationship with a wild animal, but they're missing the entire point. The sea lion is only there for your food, it does not care about your company, and now you've stopped giving it food, which you shouldn't have been doing in the first place, but then you did, and now you've stopped. And this is a cause for obvious frustration for the animal. And then people are like reaching out to it. This is so scary. They literally encourage the girl to sit beside it so that they can take a picture of her and the animal. And then he does something called displaced aggression. Apparently you only get one warning with this guy. And displaced aggression is when your anger is directed at something that is not actually the source of the provocation. Like if I had a bad day at work, unfortunately, the person most likely to feel that is my partner at home. This sea lion doesn't want to eat the girl. As far as I know, there are zero cases of seals or sea lions consuming humans. That's not what's happening here. He's just mad that the food has stopped.
Oh my God, oh my God!
Okay, I think this was her grandfather, if I remember correctly. He jumps right into the water to save her. Good for him. He had zero hesitation, so I appreciate that. But where was that protective instinct a second ago when this extremely large, dangerous animal was getting very close to the kid? Earlier, we compared sea lions to bears because they're very similar to bears. In fact, a sea lion's closest land relative is a bear. And male California sea lions can be even heavier than grizzly bears. Would you do this with a grizzly bear? Would anyone put their kid next to a hungry grizzly bear?
Good morning.
Why is a sea lion any different? They're huge, they're dangerous.
Good job, Chunky Monkey.
The family in this case didn't actually know that a bite from one of these animals should be any concerning than any other type of scratch. And she was bit. So the facility I was at the time actually reached out to the family to let them know that if she was bit by this animal, she needed to go to the hospital now. Completely predictable. Completely predictable outcome. And now, of course, we're going to run away from the consequences of our own actions are chasing us down this dock. So the moral of the story here, leave sea lions alone. Leave wild animals alone. Observe them from a safe distance. Don't feed them. Don't try to take selfies with them. And especially stop putting your kids in dangerous situations. And while I don't know for sure if that's what caused the sea lions to chase the beachgoers in the first video, I think it's probably a safe bet. What do you think? Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll catch you next time. Cheers.
Good. Vocal. There's no sound coming out of your mouth. Sir? It sounds like a squeaky. No. Vocal.